Now, and later on, actually, the same guys, they also came up with this formal relation between SVD and Wirtz-Tuwick, which is again under some assumptions, but I am not going to do the proof here, I am just going to give you the intuition. So, recall that SVD does a matrix factorization of the co-occurrence matrix. Levy et al. Showed that Wirtz-Tuwick also does such an implicit matrix factorization. So, what does this mean? So, recall that Wirtz-Tuwick gives us W context and W word, it gives us these two parameters. So, they say that there exists a matrix M such that, okay, this is wrong, just be the product of two matrices, right. This is the product of two matrices, it should be W context transpose W word, or just see which way the transpose should be, okay. So, it is actually a product of these two matrices that you have learnt, okay. And what is M? M is actually nothing but the PMI matrix minus this log K. Where does the K come from? What was K? The negative samples that you had taken. So, they actually showed that whatever representations Wirtz-Tuwick runs, it is actually doing a factorization of this matrix, where this matrix has a strong connection to the PMI matrix, and SVD also works with the PMI matrix, right. So, if you take SVD matrix and do these modifications to it, that means you take every value which is the PMI and then subtract this log K from that and then just do an SVD of that, you will essentially get back the same word representations as Wirtz-Tuwick, okay. There were some subtle assumptions made in the paper, but that is, I mean, I do not want to go into those. But the key idea here is that you can actually show that SVD and Wirtz-Tuwick are actually connected. And if you think about it, right, at an intuitive level, both these methods are relying on the same underlying principle, that words appear together, based on that their word representations get updated, or in SVD, based on their counts get updated, and you then eventually end up with certain representation, right. So, the underlying principle is the same. So, there has to be a connection, right. It is not that they are doing fundamentally something different. Both of them are relying on the idea of co-occurrence or the idea of distribution, right. So, they have to at some level be similar in some ways, right. So, that is what they finally showed. And so, now, but still in most applications, Wirtz-Tuwick is preferred. So, one reason for that is that this is an iterative training procedure, right. As compared to SVD, and I come back to your question, right, how do you do that, how do you compute the eigenvectors of X transpose X? And the answer is there is no simple way of doing that, right. You have to do that expensive matrix multiplication and then rely on various very smart libraries for computing the eigenvectors, which are still order n raised to 2 point something or something like that. They are not order n cube, but they are still order n raised to 2 point something, right. So, they are still expensive. And then of course, you have this memory issue that if you have a very large vocabulary, your PMI matrix is going to be very high dimensional, and then you need to do the factorization of that high dimensional matrix, right. So, that runs into these computational efficiency issues. On the other hand, Wirtz-Tuwick by design is an iterative algorithm, because you are going to do gradient descent, which is that every time step you are going to update some parameters of the model. You are not learning all the parameters together, you are only dealing with some parameters at every time step, right. So, that is more computationally efficient, especially if you do the contrastive divergence or the negative sampling or the hierarchical softmax, right. So, that is why perhaps it is still more popular than SVD, okay. So, that is where we end this lecture.